At Henry Ford, we do dozens of awake craniotomies every year. We have a lot of experience doing those types of procedures, and because we're always looking to maximize the amount of tumor we can take out and preserve as much function as we can. There's a lot of preparation for an awake craniotomy. In most cases, we have to meet with our speech and language therapy team, because one of the main indications for an awake craniotomy is when tumors involve the speech or language area or a motor area. We'll have to meet with our neurophysiology team that we use to map things out in surgery. And then we have a specific team of anesthesia colleagues that work with us on these cases.
The neuroanesthesiologist is a participant in every portion of the surgical procedure. We are catering the sedation specific for that patient. We are in constant communication with the surgeon in terms of timing to be awake, and also with our neurophysiologists in terms of what they're seeing on the monitoring to know our depth of anesthesia to be appropriate for the timing of the procedure.
From the patient's perspective during an awake craniotomy, when they come into the operating room, they're surrounded by people they've already met before, whether that's me, the surgeon, the anesthesia team, or the speech and language folks. They typically will get some sedation, numbing medication, patients will be positioned, and they'll be asleep, and we're getting the portion of the tumor prepared and exposed and ready for surgery. Following that, patients wake up slowly, and they'll go through a series of tests or paradigms where they may just talk with us, or they may do some counting, or they may do some naming.
This is a duck.
Right.
This is a fire truck.
After that, while we're monitoring for these types of functionality, speech, language, or motor, we'll pick safe spots to then go ahead and take out the tumor.
Patients typically do remember some portions of the procedure before and after the testing portion. Typically, it's not described as anything uncomfortable. By and large, it's sedation before testing, awake during testing, sedation after testing.
So after an awake craniotomy, patients' attitudes, and perception of the surgery is generally a positive one. I think a lot of patients really enjoy participating in getting that tumor out of their head. And they're a super critical part of the team when it comes to that, because we rely heavily on their feedback during surgery, and the more feedback we get, the more tumor gets removed.